Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss about the next topic, that is fertilization and implantation. So first of all, what is fertilization? We have so many times discussed about this definition. Fertilization is actually the fusion of sperm and the ova, or you can say the fusion of male and female gamete. Here two things are very important. First of all, the male gamete is motile, where the female gamete is non-motile, right? We have discussed this earlier. We have discussed it earlier in the previous sections. So no need to write it. You can just remember those things. First of all, the sperm, that is the male gamete, it is motile. So it has to produce in large number so as to compensate their loss. Approximately some of the sperms are being destroyed in the female vaginal tract, or some they are non-motile. They don't have that much of mitochondria which provides the energy. So there are number of reasons why they are produced in large amount. Now for fertilization you have to learn about the structure of ovum. So the structure of ovum Here I have prepared, I have made the plasma membrane, as all the cells contain the plasma membrane as their important layer or the membrane. Here in between this is the nucleus, this is the cytoplasm, and here it is plasma membrane. This is space between the plasma membrane, this is plasma membrane. And this is perivitelline space. This is the new term for you. So this is perivitelline space. Perivitelline space. Okay. Now you will see one of the layer, that is zona pellucida, around it. This is zona pellucida. And here I am shading it with the red color, the perivitelline space, okay, so that you can recognize it properly. So this is perivitelline space in red colored I have mentioned, and the space between this this portion, this white portion, this is zona pellucida. This is again a new term. See the spellings properly. Then zona pellucida, around it there are some cells known as corona radiata, because these are radiating outwards. These are radiating outwards, that's why they are radiata, corona radiata. You can make in this shape. Okay, you can make 2-3 layers. Okay, so this is the structure of ovum. You can see some of the sperms are being approaching to it. This is one of the sperm, means it enters still corona radiata only. Some of the sperm I am showing you here, it has reached up to zona pellucida. Some of the sperms, they I am showing you till they are being entered into the corona radiata. Some questions are being asked from this topic, structure of ovum itself, that 5 marks question has been came in one of the year, I think 2018, I suppose. Okay, so this sperm will fertilize the ovum. We will see the reason why only one sperm fuses with the ovum. So it is the structure of ovum. Inside it is the cytoplasm. This is the nucleus. Then the plasma membrane, then perivitline space, then zona, and then corona radiata. There is one more key point you can learn it, CZPM. CZPM. C stands for corona. Corona radiata. I suppose you will remember this time very carefully. Corona radiata. From the coronavirus, you can learn it. Zona pellucida. This is zona. Then perivitline. And then plasma membrane. Okay. This is zona pellucida. Then perivitline space. Perivitline. Space. And finally, this is plasma membrane. So, membrane. Okay. So, you have to learn it from this thing. CZPM, you can remember. After one and the other, membrane will come. Now, come to fertilization. As we have discussed the structure of ovum, now you will feel easy to learn what is how the fertilization occurs. During fertilization, the sperm, in the sperm head, one enzyme was there, that is acrosome, that was present in the sperm's head. The sperm head, it contained one enzyme known as acrosome. This enzyme will help in fertilization or fusing. Fertilization. Okay, so this will rupture the corona radiata. After that, it will rupture the zona pellucida. Then it will rupture the corona radiata and so on. It will move to till the plasma membrane. Now, till here, the head will come and the tail will get shed off. Means tail will be removed from the sperm. Because the function of swimming is now stopped. No swimming of the sperm is required, so tail will be shed off. Only the head will get inside, and from the head only the nucleus and the centriole. Centriole was present in the neck region. The function of centriole here, it was present in the neck region. Centriole, it will help in the formation of spindle fiber. Mention it somewhere else. This centriole. Centriole will help in formation of spindle fiber. Okay, that will help in divisions. So, sperm head contains acrosome. It will lead to the fertilization. Here, as soon as the sperm fertilizes with the ovum, it releases all its head content along with the centriole. Nucleus will go inside the ovum. The centriole will also go into the, some of the ions are present. These ions will block these ions when the sperm head will go inside it. Some of the ions like calcium ion. Okay, so it will changes the potential of the membrane. How it will change? Let's say this is the egg. Nucleus is there and the sperm head. As soon as the sperm comes, tail is being shed off. Okay. Tail is being shed off. Okay. So, it is being removed, cut down. And its content, it will release this ovum. This is ovum. Okay. So, it will shed all the contents into the ovum. It will shed all the content into the ovum. Now what will happen? Its content contains some of the ions. As ovum is a cell, and all these cells, whenever they are at rest, inside it is negatively charged. That also we have discussed in class 11. And here it will be outside, it will be positively charged. Okay, cell at rest is in this situation. As soon as the content are released, as I am telling you that it is rich in calcium ions, you have also studied. calcium ions will be released. So now calcium has positive ions, and these positive ions will increase the positive charge inside. Now the charge will change. It will become positive and the outside will become negative. From outside it will become negative. Okay, now what will happen? The potential of the egg is decreased or changed. It will block the entry of other sperms. Now if any sperm want to fertilize this ovum, no sperm can enter or fertilize this ovum. That is how it blocks the other sperms to fertilize. Okay, now after this nucleus will also bind to it. Fine. Nucleus, this is the nucleus of the sperm. So it will now become the zygote. Now it will become diploid. One of the nucleus is of the ovum and one of the nucleus is of the sperm. Now it will become zygote. Next thing. Now if we talk about how it will convert into the embryo, you know, so zygote will again divide further into the fallopian tube. One more important thing is there, where this fertilization is occurring. So in the fallopian tube that you have studied in class 10, but now you are in class 12, so you have to learn the specific position, and that is ampullary isthmic junction. So fertilization occurs at ampullary isthmic junction. Okay, so this is the site where fertilization occurs. This you need to learn it very carefully. Now come to the next thing. One more important thing is there, at this stage when the fertilization occurs, here it completes its meiotic division. In the schematic diagram of oogenesis, we have studied that this meiotic division was halted in the prophase 1, and just after the birth it was started. Then in the meiotic 2, then it again halted. And here after the fertilization it will complete its meiotic division, and the secondary oocyte is being converted into the zygote then. Now we will discuss how the sex of the baby is being determined. So there are 23 pairs of chromosome in a human cell. Those 23 cells, 23 chromosomes, the first 22 are autosomal.